Okay, next operation is multiplication of matrices. How do we find the product of two matrices? Okay, before we find out how two matrices are multiplied, we need to check for their compatibility. Okay, only if they are compatible, so we can multiply both matrices. So, how do we know if two matrices can be multiplied? Okay, I will explain on next slide how to multiply matrices. Okay, let's try example 9 in your notes. So, suppose we have the following matrix A, okay, equal to 1, 0, 2, 3, negative 1, 4. So this matrix has two rows and three columns. So we say this is a 2x3 matrix. Okay, suppose we want to multiply matrix A by the following matrix B. Okay, given that matrix B equal to 1, negative 3, 5, 1, 4, 2. So this is a 3x2 matrix. It has 3 rows and 2 columns. Okay, in order to be able to multiply matrices, the number of columns in your first matrix, matrix A, has to be equal to the number of rows in matrix B. Okay, so this value must be the same value. So basically, the numbers on the inside must be the same value. If these two numbers are different, you cannot multiply the two matrices. Okay? If the two values on the inside are the same, the size of the resulting matrix when you do multiply actually comes from the outside. This one. Okay? Outside numbers. So, if you look at the outside numbers, okay, you have 2 and a 2. Okay, and if I were to multiply these two matrices, matrix A and matrix B, you would find that you will get a resulting matrix of 2x2 matrix. Okay, resulting matrix of 2x2. Okay, let's proceed. Since the inside values are the same, so we will get a 2x2 matrix at the end. What you are doing is, you are multiplying rows by columns. So you just multiply the first row of matrix A by the first column of matrix B. Okay, so open bracket for a matrix. Okay, let's start. So 1 times 1, okay, the first entry of the first row of matrix A multiply with the first entry of the first column of matrix B, okay, and then plus, okay, 0 times 5, so 0 times 5 here, plus, and then move 2 times 4, okay, 2 times 4, okay, when I simplify all this down, that is going to be the number that goes in the top left corner of a matrix, okay, and then I just repeat this process with the first row of matrix A, but now I move to the next column of matrix B. Okay, over here. Okay. So just repeat the same process. So 1 times negative 3 over here plus 0 times 1, okay, and then followed by 2 times 2. Okay, close. If there was another column, okay, over here, I would do this again. Just start over and start over again. I now repeat this process with the second row of matrix A, multiply by the first column of matrix B. Okay, let's start. 3 times 1 plus negative 1 times 5 plus 4 times 4. Okay, and then we move to the second column of matrix B over here. Okay, so second row of matrix A multiply with the second row of matrix B. Okay, let's start. 3 times negative 3 plus negative 1 times 1 plus 4 times 2. Okay, and finish. We just close the bracket. Okay, and then simplify your answer. Okay, so equal to open bracket. Okay, simplify the first element, you will get 9, 1, 14, negative 2. So it is 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, let's try exercise 3 in your notes together. Given that matrix A and matrix B, so I've got 4, 2, 3, 1 for matrix A, and then we multiplying this by matrix B. The order of matrix A is 2 by 2 matrix, and the order of matrix B is 2 by 3 matrix, 2 rows and 3 columns for matrix B. Okay, again, the numbers on the inside match up. Okay, so we can multiply them, and the final matrix should be 2 by 3 matrix. Okay, this one is the final matrix letter. Okay, and let's see if that does in fact happen here. Okay, let's try. Okay, how to find matrix A times matrix B? So again, I am basically taking the first row of matrix A and multiplying that by the first column of matrix B. Okay, and then open big bracket. So if I multiply, I will get 4 times 2 plus 2 times 3. And then move to the next column of matrix B. Okay, over here. So you just multiply the first row of matrix A with the second column of matrix B straight away. So you will get 4 times 1 plus 2 times 2. Okay? And then I will move over one more time to the third column of matrix B. First row of matrix A times with the third columns of matrix B. You will get 4 times 0 plus 2 times 1. And then close the bracket. Now I move to the second row of matrix A. Okay. And I will start this process all over again. Multiply second row of matrix A with the first column of matrix B. 3 times 2 plus 1 times 3. And move over to next column of matrix B. Okay. Second row of matrix A times with the second column of matrix B. 3 times 1 plus 1 times 2. And lastly, last column of matrix B. Okay. So second row of matrix A times with the third column of matrix B. You will get 3 times 0 plus 1 times 1. Okay. Next step, you need to simplify your answer. Okay. Equal to, okay, 4 times 2 plus 2 times 3, you will get 14, and add 2, 9, 5, 1. Okay, and this will be your final answer. So notice we do in fact end up with a 2 by 3 matrix.